Hello students, today we are going to discuss the environment and ecology unit from the water supply engineering subject. In this video we are going to study the contents, various stages of pipe laying and its testing, pipe corrosion and remedial measures, the laying of water supply pipelines. Pipes are generally laid below the ground level, but sometimes when they pass in open areas they may be laid over the ground. The pipes are laid in the following way. First of all, the detailed map of all routes, street lanes, etc. or so on is prepared. On this map, the proposed pipeline with all sizes and lengths will be marked. The position of existing pipeline, curb lines, sewer lines will be marked on it. In addition to this, position of valves and other pipe specials, stand posts will also be marked so that at the time of laying there should not be difficulty in the connection. After the general planning, the center line of the pipeline will be transferred on the ground. From the detailed plan, the center line will be marked by means of stakes driven at 30 meter interval on straight lines. On curves, the stakes will be driven at 7 to 15 meter spacing. If road or streets have curves, the distance of center of pipeline from curb will be marked. Next, first we will be excavating and marking the center lines. Next, we will be laying without disturbing the previous lines. Next, checking the valves. Next, connecting all the pipes with joints. Lastly, laid pipelines. Now we will be testing on laid pipelines. There is a hydrostatic test, pressure test at a pressure of at least double of maximum water pressure. Pipe joints shall be absolutely watertight. Leakage test to be conducted after the satisfactory completion of the pressure test at a pressure as specified by the authority for a duration of 2 hours. So this is what happens when the after 2 hours checkup, if it is hydrostatic test, the joint, it might gets cracked and it starts flowing outside. And this is what happened when the hydrostatic test, it's been they were checking the pressure test, the pipe, it's been cut, and at last it is the hydrostatic test apparatus how they are going to conduct the test. Next, the pipe corrosion and remedial measures. The pipeline corrosion occurs naturally due to the gradual and continuous environmental attack on pipe materials. It can happen on inside as well as outside surfaces. Pipe materials affected by corrosion include metal and non-metal pipes, pipe joints, welds and surface coatings. Ensure there are no dissimilar metals, or make sure they are isolated. Spot repair leaks using gear clamps or other temporary devices. Use a water treatment system to adjust water quality and pH values. A drastic measure is to repipe the whole building or part that has corrosion. So this is a video, and I have been put in my PPT. Please go through this video, and if you have any queries, please ask. Thank you. This finishes with the first unit, and we'll start with the next unit in the fresh mode. And if you have any doubts in all the videos, please let me know. Thank you.